It's said that a human being's journey is to find their true purpose, their dharma. So in the Bhagavad Gita, and this may take many lifetimes, the sense that I get is that your sense of purpose, your dharma, you feel very strong in. It gives you energy, it gives you direction. You have to deal with practicalities. You're not absent from the world. You have to manage projects, people. They say that one of the most difficult things to manage is people. But you seem to get energy from it. You think it's your dharma to be a leader with people, not of people, but with people?
The description of my work, or rather, if you want to know what this work is all about, it is the work of a wounded healer. And I consider Jesus, my supreme yogi, as a wounded healer. All my staff, 98%, 99%, in some centers, are wounded healers, people in recovery, and sharing that brokenness and pain with the other. So my legacy is this, basically, that acknowledge who you are, and automatically when you see who you are, you will realize that you are a person for the other. And you'll always, even if you are a human being, as the first step says that I am an addict, I'm a human being and my life has become unmanageable. The second step of the self-help program says, came to believe that a power higher than myself can restore me to sanity. Now this power higher than myself is precisely this fellowship and this oneness that Guruji and Mother Teresa has created all over the world. You know, and that is the factor that will save the world. Let me tell you, it's going to save the world. Because slowly you realize that even affluent countries who have gone berserk with all addictions are now coming through the youth. They are realizing that there is something beyond the material, and that is the spiritual grace of God.
Kripa. So on that note, we'll finish. A wonderful conversation. Thanks for giving us your time and hearing from you.